I landed about 10:30, grabbed a rental car, and I've been driving for about 45 minutes. I've arrived at Lake Bled. I am looking forward to coming back here. This is where I'm staying, actually. I'm heading out to another lake right now, but I'm going to be coming back here in about 4 or 5 hours. This is where the hotel is for the first 2 nights. And this yellow building on the left side of the road is where I'm staying. This is my hotel tonight. I'll be back. At the car, if I turn the camera around, you'll see the kind of conditions that I'm walking in. There we go, there's the lake. You can see the huge mountains of the Julian Alps just over there. Wow, what a beautiful place! This lake is really isolated. There's a lot of parking, but there's nobody here. So I'd imagine in the summer, lots of people are sightseeing and they come and see this incredible lake with the mountains overhanging and a bit of warmth as well, I should imagine, in the summer months. Here's a little shack. And my car's just past that, the little blue Corsa. I'm at pretty much the other end now. And it's absolutely beautiful. The sunlight is falling nicely on the mountains behind me. I think you can see them, hopefully you can. And there's snow where I am here on the edge of the lake. I turn around, you might be able to see it.
I feel part of the universe opened up to meet me. My emotion so submerged, broken down to kneeling, once listening. The voices, they came. I had to somehow greet myself, greet myself. My love is safe for the universe.
Arriving now at the car park of the waterfall. There's a few cars here, that's a good sign. And I made it without getting stuck in any snow. Roads are in pretty good shape. Some skiers over on the right hand side. Okay, well, I've arrived at the Savica waterfall. This is my final stop of the day before heading back to Bled to check into the hotel. There's a lot of snow on the ground, it's very icy. And here is the entrance. I just parked the car. Here's the entrance to the Savica waterfall. I better read the instructions before I go up. Well, this is interesting. The path to the Savica waterfall is closed. Passage at your own risk. So basically, I did read something about that they don't man the desks here to take money during the winter season. So I'm going to take a slow, careful walk up there, I think. And if I meet anything I'm not too happy with, I'll just come back again. Okay, well, the conditions underfoot are not too bad so far. There's a lot of snow, but it seems to be quite well compressed. Unless you step off the footpath, and then you kind of go in this half a foot deep snow. I can hear a waterfall, or at least water moving about. That's not the one I'm after though. I think it's much bigger than that. Not that this time of year I should imagine there's going to be too much of a waterfall, because it's in spring you usually get all the water and snow melting. The size of some of these mountains around here are phenomenal. Probably seen the last of the sun because of them. And it's only 3 o'clock. Sun doesn't set until 6. Right, let's press on. On the sign it said I got a 20 minute walk. Okay, well I can see a hut. I think I've seen this on Google.
Well, I've made it to the top of Savica Waterfall here in Slovenia, and wow, what a view behind me. I've been walking uphill for about 20 minutes. I've been driving before that uphill for about 20 minutes from the lake. You might be able to see the lake just about there. That's where I was previously. All there is really is a little hut up here. So if I turn the camera around, you can see there's the little hut. And then as we come around here, there's the waterfall. I think I'm about to head back down again now. It's very quiet. I've been here about half an hour. I've seen perhaps 10, 12 people come and go. It's a dead end, so you can't keep walking. So you have to basically go back down the way you came. The temperature now is really starting to drop. It was about 4 or 5 degrees earlier, so it wasn't really that cold, but I reckon it's gone down to about zero at least, because it is really cold now. I suppose the other thing is, it might have been the walk uphill that kept me warm, and now I'm up here, I've been sitting around having a look, maybe that's what it is. So without further ado, I'm going to head back down towards the car, which is somewhere in amongst them trees. Bye-bye, Savica. Gloves are on. This slope coming down has frozen a bit more, I swear it. It's like a bobsleigh run now. See if I can slide my way down. Oh, it's slippery. Right, okay. The secret is to tread where there is still snow and not just ice. So that's what I'm gonna do. Head to the bottom. I'm about 10 minutes down the walk now. There's the little hut that I was at a few moments back. I just saw this little pier on the way back towards the hotel. This is near where I was earlier actually. Look at that, absolutely stunning. And then if I come round here, you can see this pretty incredible looking church as well.
Nice place. Wow. Nobody around at all. I'm on my own. Very few cars. Although I can see one there coming by. Just an incredible lake. So, pretty happy with what I've achieved today. That's everything that I wanted to get done. All I've got to do now is get back to the hotel. And here we are. I'm in the room. How about that? Not bad. Looks like a nice comfortable bed. Should get a pretty good view out of the window tomorrow morning. And in here, yeah, not bad. Little shower. Right, let's get a few bits on charge and then head out and get some food. I've been out, I've had a look around Bled the town, and I'm back at the hotel now, and I'm gonna head to bed, I think, get an early night, get up early in the morning, get breakfast, and then get out to the lake to have a good look around.